Hello children, good morning to all of you. I hope you must be enjoying Navratri at home, isn't it? Children, today I want to ask you certain questions, okay? Have you ever noticed that the water which we drink every day, from where it comes from? Now you will answer that the water which we drink every day, it comes from the river, lakes and so many other things, isn't it? And where do we have the foundation of our buildings? Of course, the foundation of our buildings, it is always on the land. And the air or the oxygen which we use for breathing, from where it comes from? Of course, it comes from the air. Now, all these things, whether it is land, air and water, why we are asking today such questions? Because children, all these things are very important part of our mother nature, earth. All these things makes our earth. And that's what our today's lesson number 3, the earth and its living world, isn't it? So, what is the other name for this land, water and air? Well, the other name for all these important things which are connected to the earth is spheres of the earth. Okay, again I want to repeat this. It is called the spheres of the earth. Okay, so today we are going to discuss one of such important aspect of the earth or one of such important sphere of the earth, and it is nothing but the lithosphere. Now, litho is a Greek word, children. The meaning of this litho is rock or stone. And you know very well, our land or the land which we see on the earth, it is mainly made up of rock, stone and soil. Isn't it? Again, I repeat, today, important sphere of the earth, that is lithosphere. Lithosphere means land. And this land is mainly made up of rock and soil. Now, apart from rock and soil, from on the land, you will also notice certain grasslands, you will also notice mountains, you will also see deep forests. All these things makes our land. But basically lithosphere, or mainly lithosphere, is all made up of rock and soil. So today we are going to discuss this lithosphere with the help of one magic box. Yes, children, we were talking about the magic box. As you can see here, a lot of things are there in this magic box. But as today we are going to talk about the lithosphere, what I have used is, this is the sheet which I have used, isn't it? And with the help of just simple scissor and this Fevi bond, I have made this sheet. Now in the sheet you will notice that to make the study of lithosphere more easy, we have divided the land into different continents. It's very clear over here, children. See what I have done. I have some shapes of the continents which I have cut with the help of scissor, and then I have pasted on the sheet to make the 3D effect. So here you can see different continents. So in all together, for lithosphere, we have divided the lithosphere into 7 major continents. See, North America, South America, Europe, Africa, Asia, Australia and Antarctica. But one more thing you will notice here, children. Out of all these 7 major continents, which is the largest continent which you notice here on the sheet? Well, it's very clear. Asia is the largest continent. And which one is the smallest continent? Of course, Australia is the smallest continent. So, with the help of this sheet, the study of continent or lithosphere becomes very easy. Again, I want to repeat the names of all major continents. It is North America, South America, Europe, Africa, Asia, Australia and Antarctica. Okay, so that's all for the today's study of lithosphere, children. In the next period, again we will meet with this magic box with some more information. So till then, bye to all of you.